after chemotherapy, and hopefully there's a lot of pain. Hypersensitive reactions. Today we'll be discussing about gout. Let's get started. Gout is the disease related to purine metabolism. You see, prepurine, during metabolism, it forms hypoxanthin, and then xanthin, and then it forms uric acids. These uric acids present in our serum get crystallized under low temperatures, and these low temperatures are observed in the lower limbs of these joints. Uric acids goes and crystallizes in the synovial fluids present in the joints, and therefore after crystallizing it increases the friction in the joint and causes a lot of rubbing of these bones together, and thereby causes frequent episodes of acute arthritis. These joints are observed with redness, swelling, and there's a lot of pain. As you can see in this diagram, in this image, we can observe redness and there's swelling, and hopefully there's a lot of pain. The most common site for this to occur is in the first metatarsophalangeal joint. It isn't necessarily symmetrical. And in gout, tophi is observed. The causes of gout may be overproduction of uric acids, or might be no secretion or decreased secretion of the uric acids. Overproduction of uric acids can be seen in only 10% of the patients, and a few diseases which show uric acid overproduction are Leish-Nehan syndrome, tumor lysis syndrome, and von Greig disease. In under-excretion of uric acids, 90% of the patients come under this category. And most of the reasons are idiopathic. Some might denote renal failure. There might be a genetic or a family history of gout. Gout can be classified based on the duration in which it is present. It might be acute or it might be chronic. How to treat gout? Acute gout can be treated by mainly three drugs: the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, colchicine, and corticosteroids. The most common NSAID which is used is the indomethacin. All the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs can be used except aspirin, because aspirin causes retention of uric acid in the renal tubules. But there is one exception. Colchicine prevents polymerization of the microtubules. Thereby, it inhibits chemotaxis of the leukocytes. This in turn inhibits phagocytosis. You can check out my notes through the link in the description. There are certain adverse effects of colchicine. These are diarrhea. Vomiting is sometimes seen, nausea, and abdominal pain. Corticosteroids are given during severe acute gout, and these are orally administered. The corticosteroid mainly preferable is the prednisone. Chronic gout. In chronic gout, there are a total of four drugs. The main, allopurinol, uricosuric drugs, febuxostat, peglotikase. In allopurinol, it is a purine-derived xanthin oxidase inhibitor. It competitively inhibits. By competitively inhibiting xanthin oxidase, it decreases the uric acid levels in the plasma. This is the first line of treatment. Allopurinol is always administered along with NSAIDs, because allopurinol may sometimes retain into acute gout, which will immediately be treated by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Allopurinol can be used to treat Leish-Nehan syndrome and Chagas disease. We must be careful about the hypersensitive reactions occurring in allopurinol. Due to this hypersensitivity, Stevens-Johnson syndrome may occur, which shows up with mild rashes. Allopurinol may cause a rare and lethal disease known as Dress syndrome, which presents with eosinophilia and is observed after 2 to 8 weeks of administration. And it presents with lymphadenopathy, facial edema, and diffused rashes. Uricosuric drugs. The main uricosuric drug used is probenecid, which decreases tophi. Lesinurad is a new drug. Probenecid is a sulfa drug, so we should be cautious about sulfa allergies. This drug increases uric acid excretion. Therefore, these uric acid which is excreted may get deposited and cause calculi. Therefore, keeping the patient well hydrated is really important. Probenecid inhibits excretion of drugs like penicillin. High doses of aspirin acts like probenecid. Febuxostat. It is a non-purine xanthan oxidase inhibitor. Pegloticase. It is used for refractory chronic gout. When all these other drugs does not help in curing this disease, at that time only pegloticase is used. It is only administered via IV. The urate oxidase enzyme present in it converts uric acid into allantoin. This enzyme is naturally present in birds. Allantoin is highly water soluble, which is really easy to excrete. Administrating this drug might cause anaphylaxis, which is observed in 6-15% of the patients. It might cause hemolysis in G6PD deficient patients. The tumor lysis syndrome. After chemotherapy, there is a sudden breakdown of cells. The DNAs, the purines are metabolized. It suddenly increases the level of uric acid. It is common with treatment of lymphoma and acute lymphoblastic leukemia. There is increased purine metabolism, which in turn increases uric acid production. It is a form of chronic gout, pseudogout. Pseudogout is otherwise known as calcium pyrophosphate deposition disease. As the name denotes, calcium pyrophosphate gets deposited in the synovial fluid. The treatment is same like acute gout. The samples under polarized light are observed to be rhomboid shaped, whereas in gout, it is needle shaped. I hope this video was useful for you. I'll see you next time. Be awesome.